So, where were I? Was talking about this translation motion. In order to find this period of this motion, because the question is, what is the period of this motion? In order to find the period of this motion, I have to find the linear speed of the center of mass of this rotating, small rotating wheel. I have to find its center of mass speed. Once I find the center of mass speed, the period is nothing but, is going to be 2 pi, the radius of this circular motion, which is going to be, let's say, r, divided by the center of mass speed. Well, this is prime, because this v and this v are not the same. This v prime, let's call the center of mass speed of the smaller wheel in this direction. And this r, from this point to this center, from the center of the inner wheel to the center of the smaller wheel, it is just r1 plus 0.1, and it makes 1.1 centimeters, 1.1 centimeters. Okay, I hope you follow this. Okay, from this point to this point, from the picture of the problem, it is just 1.1. And you put this 1.1 in this equation, and v prime, we are going to find now the center of mass speed of the smaller wheel on this direction. And then we can find the period. But, you know, how to find v prime now? What is v prime? Well, we know that, remember this, I have talked this before. I was discussing, I was discussing about this bike wheel that is going with some linear speed and rolling with omega, right? If it's rolling with omega, if it has a radius of r, it's doing a rolling motion. I told you that the point that it touches the ground at any moment in time is zero. Okay. This point is zero, has zero velocity, while the center of mass has velocity v, and this point right at the top is going to have a velocity of 2v. Okay. And v and omega are related to each other by this equation. Okay. Now, think about this point. As I said, this point has a linear velocity of this, v. If this top point, with respect to, you know, motion of this small wheel, if you view the motion of the small wheel in compared to this picture, this is going to be top point, this is going to be center, and this is going to be bottom. While rolling, the top point is will go with a speed of twice that of the speed of the center of mass. So I know what this speed is, right? And the center of mass speed is going to be just half of this one. I mean v prime. V prime is going to be just v divided by 2. You get this?
Hocam neden yarısı aldık? Ben o kısmı anlayamadım.
Şurada anlatmaya çalıştım.
Orada kopmuştum aslında. Sonradan bağlar mıyım diye sormadım ama tamamlayamadım.
Evet. Şimdi bir tekerleği düşünelim. Gerçi burada düz bir zemin üstüne gidiyor ama bunun düz olması önemli değil. Yani şöyle bu yüzeyin circular da olması bir şey değiştirmeyecek. Tamam mı? Böyle bir tekerleği düşünelim. Şöyle bir circular track üzerinde, dairesel bir yol üzerinde yuvarlanarak gidiyor. Böyle bir dairesel yol üzerinde yuvarlanarak giden bu tekerlek, eğer merkezi, tabii ki merkezi merkezinde bulunan bir noktanın hızı v olacak, değil mi? Çizgisel hızı. Eğer bu v ise, bu tekerleğin tam yere değdiği noktanın çizgisel hızının sıfır olması lazım. Çünkü kayarak gitmiyor tekerlek. Yuvarlanarak gidiyor. Yuvarlanarak gittiği için bu noktanın hızı, tekerlek üzerindeki bu noktanın hızı, yere değen hızı her zaman tekerlek hangi hızla yuvarlanırsa yuvarlansın sıfır olmak zorunda. Merkezi ve tam en üst noktasının çizgisel hızı da merkezinin hızının iki katı olmak zorunda. Bunu daha önce anlatmıştım.
Tamam hocam. Tamam. Teşekkür ederim. Şu an daha iyi.
O yüzden buradaki hız eğer V ise şunun hızının buna göre yarısı olması lazım. Buradaki şeyden dolayı, özellikten dolayı bakın. En yukarıdaki noktanın hızı, çizgisel hızı 2V ise merkezin V, buranın da 0. Dolayısıyla bu hızı bulduk. Bu hızı bulduk. Bunun hızı bunun yarısı olmak zorunda. Okay. Now, I think the rest is okay now. All you have to do is just now make some necessary conversions. Okay. So, what was V prime now? V prime is V divided by 2, but V is given in terms of 12 RPM multiplied by centimeters. All right. So that means V prime is going to be 6 RPM centimeter. And I have to make a conversion that if you make convert the centimeters into meters, you have to divide this by 100, 6 divided by 100. And RPM should be converted to radian per second because, you know, I have to find the period in terms of seconds. You have to multiply this by 2 pi divided by 60 seconds, okay? So then V prime in terms of meter per second is this one. 6 divided by 100, 2 pi divided by 60. Okay. Then if you put everything over here, the period is going to be 2 pi r. R is 1.1 centimeters, but 1.1 divided by 100 because I am converting into meters. Divided by inverse of divided by V prime and take the inverse of this, 100 multiplied by 60, divide this by 6 times 2 pi. So these 2 pi's will cancel out, these hundreds will cancel out, and this 60 divided by 6 is 10, so T period is going to be 11 seconds. And this is the answer to the problem. Şimdi bu problemin zorluğu arkadaşlar, bu hareketi biraz tasarlamakta, kafanızda tasarlamakta geçirebilirsiniz. The one thing that difficulty about this problem is difficult to realize, you know, the motion of the inner wheel while this, the wheel in between, while the inner wheel is rotating and this one is fixed, and what kind of motion is going to have this smaller wheel. So it is difficult to realize in your mind, but anyway, if you are careful enough, you will be able to figure it out. Okay, so this is the solution. If you have something in you want to ask, you may ask. If not, I will just continue with the next question. Bununla alakalı birkaç tane daha problem var şeyde. You have more problems regarding the same picture in Canvas quizzes. Try to solve them. Okay. Next. When a solid uniform sphere is spinning about an axis through its center, its rotational kinetic energy is K. Let's draw again in a picture. Let's imagine a sphere, okay, with some radius r, with a total mass m. It is spinning with some angular velocity omega. Okay, this is the first sphere. So with this, it has a kinetic energy K. First of all, how do you express the kinetic energy for a rotating sphere? It's not moving, it's not rolling, it's just rotating, that's it, around this center. How do you express this kinetic energy? Well, remember, it is 1/2 I omega square, right? And I, the moment of inertia for the sphere, is 2 divided by 5 m r square. Okay. A second solid sphere having twice the mass and twice the diameter as the first one. So I have to draw a second sphere which has the radius of 2r and a mass of 2m. Again, it's spinning around its center, twice the angular velocity. So it is spinning with 2 omega. The rotational kinetic energy of the second sphere in terms of K, how many Ks is going to be? So let's this call this one I1, so K1. This is I1. Okay. What about K2? K2 is going to be 1/2 I2 times omega 2 omega squared. Well, since the angular speed is now 2 omega squared. So obviously, in order to find K2 in terms of K1, you have to find I2 in terms of I1. And I2 is going to be 2 divided by 5. Well, the mass is twice, 2m, and the radius is twice. So 2r squared is 4r squared. So it's going to be 2 divided by 5 m r squared. 2 times 4, which is 8. So obviously this says that I2 is going to be 8 times that of I1. Okay. So I2 is 8 times I1, 1/2, and take the square of this 8 I1, and take the square of this 4 omega squared. And let me erase this part. Let's arrange this 1/2 I1 omega squared multiply 8 by 4, 32. So this one is nothing but K1 or K. So it is 32 times K. So in the second case, the kinetic energy is going to be 32 times the kinetic energy of the first one. This is the answer. Okay. This was simple. But you have to know what the moment of inertia of a sphere is. Okay. So, this was it. What about the next one? The next question. The next question is a moment of calculation of a moment of inertia. An object is made up of three masses connected by massless rods of fixed length. Mass A is located at this and this and has a mass of 250 grams. Mass B is located at there and has a mass of 350 grams. Mass C is located at blah, 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 has a mass of 450 grams. What is the moment of inertia of this object about an axis perpendicular to the XY plane passing through the origin? Again, and have to draw the coordinate system first. All right, this is y and this is x, and let's label the masses now. A is located 30 centimeters to zero, so it's on the x-axis. This is 30 centimeters, and this is MA, and it is 250 grams. And B is on the y-axis, and it is 40 centimeters. And B has a mass of 350 grams. Okay. And C is at negative x-axis, somewhere over here, minus 20. And C is 450 grams. Okay. And they are rotating around this axis, okay? Around the z-axis. They are rotating all together because they are connected by sticks. They are rotating around this origin. If they are rotating around this origin, according to this, with respect to this axis, z-axis, what is the moment of inertia of this three-mass system? This is the question. Well, since they are point particles, for example, take the mass A. If it is rotating around this axis, and the rotation of it's going to be a radius of a circle of radius 30 centimeters, right? So obviously, its moment of inertia is going to be just its mass multiplied by the distance squared. And you do the same calculation for the rest of these two masses. This mass B multiplied by 4 centimeters squared, mass C multiplied by 20 centimeters squared. So add them all, you will find the moment of inertia of the system. Then the moment of inertia is going to be mass A, 250 gram. Well, you have to convert everything into kilogram and meters. 0.25 multiplied by 0.3 meters squared plus 0.35 multiplied by 0.4 squared plus 0.45 multiplied by 0.2 squared. And do the math, do the calculation, that's it. The unit is going to be kilogram meter square. Okay. So 32K bir önceki soruda 32K bulan cevap anahtarında 2K gösterilmiş. Bazı soruların cevabı yanlış girilmiş arkadaşlar. Ama onlar düzeltilecek. Okay, so this was again simple. What is the next question? Okay. A horizontal disk rotates about a vertical axis through its center, a disk. A point P is midway between the center and the rim of the disk, and the point Q is on the rim. If the disk turns with a constant angular velocity, which of the following statements about it true? So let's again draw our picture somewhere over here, maybe. Okay. This is the center, let's say. This is point P, and this is point Q. So if this distance, if from here to here the distance r, from here to here this is going to be r, so the disk will have a radius of 2r, and the disk rotates with a constant angular velocity omega 0. So let's check the first statement. The linear acceleration of p is twice as great as the linear acceleration of q. So what is linear acceleration? The linear acceleration in this problem, since it's a uniform circular motion, is nothing but the centripetal acceleration. But the centripetal acceleration of a point on a rotating object is just, I think, omega square times r, like v square over r, and v is always related to omega by omega times r. If you put v square over r, v instead of omega r, you get omega square r. I'm just taking the omega zero as omega. So the point P, linear acceleration is going to be, well, for both points, omega zero is going, the angular speed is going to be same. Angular speed is not going to change for points anywhere on the disk. And for P, it is omega zero squared multiplied by the distance to the center is r. But for point Q, it is going to be omega zero squared, but distance to the center is 2r. So the linear acceleration of P is half of the linear acceleration of Q. So the first statement is not true. Obviously, it's the other way around. If you just change P by Q and Q by P, then it's going to be true, but it's not. So the linear acceleration of Q is just twice as great as linear acceleration of P. The first statement is not true. The second statement is that linear acceleration of Q is twice as great as linear acceleration of P, which is true. And this one is true. And next statement is Q is moving twice as fast P. Q is moving twice as P. That means what is the linear speed of Q and the linear speed of P? Well, linear speed of P is just omega zero times r, but the linear speed of Q is omega zero times 2r. So that means, in fact, it's true that it is 2 times Vp. It is true that Q is moving twice as fast as P. So this one is also true. And the next statement is angular velocity of Q is twice as great as the angular speed. It's not true. The angular velocity of every point on the disk is the same, omega zero. And next is P and Q have the same linear acceleration, which is not true because we already calculate their linear acceleration, which are different. Okay, only two statements are correct for this problem. Okay. Any questions? No. So this was again simple problem. Okay, next one is, in fact, this problem is this problem is called ballistic pendulum. It is the ballistic pendulum problem. It's from chapter of this linear momentum, the momentum chapter. Anyway, let's do this. But solving this problem requires both the conservation of momentum and conservation of energy. So, probably you may wonder that, the speed of a bullet out of a gun. How do you measure the speed of a bullet out of a gun? And this is known as ballistic, and its ballistic calculations are done for this kind of simple bullet speed measurements by using this system that you have a large block. Well, in this problem, it's 1.5 kilograms. It's hanged by a string, and it's at steady at the bottom, and they just shot the block by the bullet, okay? And the bullet, you have the knowledge of its mass. In this problem, it's just 10 grams, 0.01 kilograms. And once they shot, the ballot will just emerge into the block and they will move together because this is a pendulum. They will move together to a distance in the vertical axis to a point which is a maximum point, and momentarily it will stay at rest over here. Momentarily, this is going to be maximum height in compared to its initial bottom position. So this height is also given, the maximum height. And by measuring this height, it's easier because if you record this by a camera, and then just you can measure it. Remember, we are doing these measurements in tracker. We just, follow the distances of objects on tracker with respect to some origin, etc. So by a scale, we can always measure this distance easily. So by measuring this distance, maximum distance that the pendulum is rising, and knowing the mass of the pendulum block, and knowing the mass of the bullet, will be enabling us to calculate the speed of the bullet initially. So let's do it then. Okay. So, this is, first of all, when the bullet just hits the block, and of course this collision with the bullet and the block is a collision problem, right? It's a collision. And we can always do this momentum conservation of momentum process for this collision, because we know what the speed of the we don't know, of course, but supposedly we know, supposedly there is the velocity of the bullet before the collision, and before the collision the block is at rest. So the total momentum before the collision is only the momentum of the bullet. After the bullet collides with the block, it will emerge into it, and this takes usually a very short amount of time, like on the order of milliseconds. So right after the bullet emerges into the block, both the block and the bullet will start moving with some velocity, initial velocity at the bottom together, starting the motion of this pendulum and raising to a maximum distance height, and stops there momentarily, and that's enough. So there are three points in this question. One, the event before the collision. I am just calling this event A. And the event right after the collision, the event B. And the event B, the picture in the event B is that the bullet is just inside the block, and the block and the bullet moves with some velocity, V, linear horizontal velocity, V, okay? And over here, the bullet's velocity, let's put the bullet's velocity as small V0, okay? And this V is the velocity of the bullet and the block together right after the bullet emerges into the block. Okay, this V is different than V0, obviously. And next, the point C, the bullet and the block just raise to a maximum height of 0.4 meters from the level, initial level of the block. Between A and B, between the process A and B, momentum is conserved, right? Between the process B and C, the energy is conserved. Okay, so let's express then first this V just after the collision of the block with the bullet. So let's express this V in terms of the mass of the bullet and the mass of the block. So I will call the mass of the bullet as M0, and I will call the mass of the block as M, okay? So I am just writing down then the conservation law, the momentum conservation law for A and B. So momentum for A, total momentum for A, is going to be equal to total momentum for B. So what is total momentum? PA. It's just the momentum of bullet because the block is at rest. So it is just M0 times V0. And this is going to be equal to, what is the momentum PB? Well, the momentum PB is that now we have a single mass, both the block and the bullet merge together. Their mass is M0 plus M. And they are moving with velocity V. Okay. So I'm just express, I will just express this V in terms of the other. M0 divided by M0 plus M multiplied by V0. Okay. But remember that, you know, M is 1.5 kilograms. Or 1.5 kilograms is 1,500 grams. M0 is, if you multiply this by 1,000, right, it is going to be 10 grams. So if you compare 10 to 1,015, the 1,500, it is just, you know, more than 100 times. So you just, if you look at this denominator, you can ignore M0 with respect to M. So I can just easily write down this M0 divided by M V0. Okay? Because, you know, you can always do this to simplify the equations anyway. So next, what happens between B and C? What happens between B and C? The energy is conserved. So energy at point B is equal to energy at point C. So what is energy at point B? Well, if you take this level to be height of zero, the energy at point B is just the kinetic energy of the both bullet and block moving with velocity V. So it is going to be 1/2 M0 plus M V square. And this kinetic energy is going to be equal at point C, since the both block and bullet just stops momentarily, so they will have only a potential energy at this height. So they will have M0 plus M G times H, where H is 0.4 meters. But we can always cancel these mass terms on both sides. And remember that this V and this V is the same. This V and this V, okay? And next is this V square is just 2G times H. And instead of V, because we don't care about V, we care about V0. We have to find V0. Then I will replace this V by M0 divided by MV0. So M0 divided by M squared, V0 squared is equal to 2 times G times H. If you solve this for V0, then you get in square root 2gh mass of bullet divided, so mass of the block divided by the mass of the bullet. So this is the initial speed of the bullet before it hits the block. So next is just, you know, divide this mass to this mass, you get 150, right, multiplied by 2 times 9.8 times 0.4 in squared. So multiply this by 150, you get V0. Okay, let's do this. I mean, I'm curious about this, really, this velocity. I will just do this multiplication. Well, to make it simple, if I take this to be 10, it is 4, and 4 will go to 2, square root, if you take the square root, 2 times square root 2 multiplied by 150. And 2 square root 2 is, square root 2 is 1.4. Multiply this by 2 and multiply this by 150. It is 424 meter per second. Okay. It's the speed of the bullet. It takes 400, almost half a kilometer in 1 second. Okay. All right, that's it. Any questions about this?
Hocam, string uzunluğunu hiç kullanmadık. Hani 2 metre bize uzunluk vermiş ya bir tane.
Evet.
Onun bir önemi yok mu?
Yok. Önemli olan, önemli olan şu şeyi vermiş. Yüksekliği.
Tamamdır. Hocam hani Tolga diye bir formül vardı harmonik harekette. Onu kullanarak çıkar mı bu T eşittir 2 pi kök içinde L bölüge?
Bu periyot basit sarkaçta L bölü G bir sarkacın buradan şuraya gidip tekrar buraya gelinceye kadar geçen süreyi veren formül. Basit sarkaç.
Tamam. Yani bu soruda kullanılmaz yani.
Yok, onunla alakası yok.
Tamamdır hocam. Teşekkür ederim.
Balistik sarkaç diyorum. Yani balistik. Balistik biliyorsunuz şeyle alakalı. Silahlarla işte mermilerin hızıyla falan alakalı bir bilim dalı. Okay, next question. Next question is sent to me in Turkish. Anyway, it's not big thing. Not big deal. I can always translate it. So, I mean, in short, what you see is that, let me draw this picture neatly, okay? So we have these two messages and a pulley, which has two different radius, and the inner radius of the pulley is connected to a block which moves in the horizontal direction, and this block has mass m1, and the outer radius of the pulley is connected to hanging mass. Okay. And this first mass, I think it has a friction with the surface. Let me, yeah. This has a friction, frictional coefficient of 0.4, I guess, yeah. And M1 is 1 kilogram, and M2 is, what is M2? 2 kilograms. The radius, the inner radius, R1, is given to be 10 centimeters, and the outer radius, R2, is given to be 20 centimeters. Okay. And what is, just take G is to be 10. And if you release the system, the question is, what is the tension that is tied, the tension in the string tied to the M2, all right? If I'm not wrong, this is this tension. Let's call this tension T2. Am I right? System service work, M2. Yes. So this is the question. Okay. So you have this system, and the system has that. Let me get remove this picture, okay? All right. So you have this system that these two blocks.